analyze for something like this. This is tetrahydrocannabinol. Or how about something like this? The primary metabolite of cocaine is benzylecognine. This is benzylecognine. Or how about this one? This is lysergic acid diethylamide, LSD. Or this is a little bit out of the realm of what we think of as analytical chemistry, but it's a very important one. How would you analyze for this guy? This is the HIV virus. This one looks like a picture of a goat. It is a picture of a goat, but I'm not changing the subject. If this goat is subjected to THC, for example, the metabolism of the goat will produce antibodies against the THC. But the goat's body will recognize this as a foreign substance and build an antibody against it. We can use this antibody as a basis for analysis for THC. The antibody is, it's like the glove and the hand scenario, or the lock and the key. The antibody conforms to the LSD according to its shape. It's a protein substance, and it fits the THC like a hand fits into a glove. Analytical chemistry is usually maybe prep the sample somehow and then just do it. An immunoassay is kind of this drama that goes on. It's like a play and it has these characters. Let me introduce the characters to you. The first character is the antibody. The antibody comes from the goat. It's a protein structure. It has a specific shape. The second character is the THC. Remember now, we're trying to analyze for THC in a specimen. It's typically urine. So we're trying to analyze for THC. The THC fits into a slot in the antibody like a key fits into a lock. Okay, there's a third character. So this is character number one is the antibody. Character number two, this is a play. Character number two is the THC, the unknown variable in the sample. Character three is, I want to call it an antibody THC complex. It's a THC complex. It's THC on one side. They say it's an analog of THC on one side, but it's got something else attached to it, which in this case is an enzyme. And so the antibody will react with the THC complex, or the antibody will react with the THC. So how do we do the analysis? Well, we take the antibody from the goat, the THC complex, which we've manufactured, and when they're mixed together, the THC complex will combine with the antibody. And it's a pretty stable material, so that's fine. So we put a sample from the patient with the unknown THC in it, in a reaction vessel, and we add to it the antibody THC complex. If the sample has THC, the THC competitively binds with the antibody. This is a common theme in immunoassays. The THC basically kicks this guy out, leaves him free, and the antibody takes over. It competitively binds. It's like the THC combines stronger with the antibody than the THC complex. And the result of this is that the amount of THC in the compound, the amount of THC in the sample is now related to the amount of this compound floating around in the reaction vessel. There's a fourth character. Let me introduce the fourth character to you. The fourth character is this red guy. The red guy is a compound that will break down with this enzyme and form a blue guy. So the enzyme on the THC complex breaks the red guy down into a blue guy, and we can detect the blue guy spectrophotometrically. The reaction cell is a spectrophotometric cell. So the THC complex is added to the sample. The THC antibody complex is added to the sample. If there's THC in it, the THC displaces this complex and these guys become free. So now the presence of this enzyme is indicative of THC in the original sample. This enzyme changes this red guy into a blue guy, and we can see it spectrophotometrically. I'm looking at this reaction and I'm thinking that this is a kinetic situation. The red enzymatically changed to blue is a kinetic situation, so the timing will be very critical. This analysis is done with a robot. Complex instrumental analysis using swinging arms and timing and computers, and everything's done with a robot. Robots are good at timing. In analytical chemistry, in general, we're not real concerned about the specifics of the situation, but it's got to be reproducible. Robots are good at that. So how does the quantitation work? Well, it's just like any other analytical chemistry application. You run standards. The standards give you a response. From the standards and the response, you make a line, and then you run unknowns, everything under the same circumstances. And under the same circumstances, the response of the samples against the line will give you a quantitation. It's a little bit different than chromatography, because in chromatography, you always have the zero, zero. Zero response is zero quantitation. In an immunoassay, you really don't have a good zero point. So you have to run at least 2 points. It's common to run 5 points, but you can't even pretend to do it without two. The antibody is specific for the THC according to its shape. So what if a molecule comes along that's the same shape as THC but is not THC? If that happens, then this analysis will give a false positive. They call it in the business, a false positive. It'll say there's THC in this when there really isn't any THC in it at all. When the USDA approved this screen in the 1970s, they said, we don't really like this, but if you want to do this, that's fine. But if you ever find a positive sample, you have to confirm it with a secondary test that's more definitive. That secondary test is GC mass spec, which is another story. So this is a screen. It's automated. There's thousands and thousands probably done every day in America for a lot of different things. I want to go back and take another look at the goat. We inject the goat with THC, or maybe the goat goes out behind the barn with his friends, I don't know. But anyway, if the goat is subjected to THC, the goat makes antibodies for THC. How does it do that? How does it know? I mean, the obvious answer, I think, would be that there's like a genetic trigger. The THC finds a THC promoter. The THC promoter says, transcribe a THC antibody piece of RNA. The THC RNA is translated into a THC peptide. The peptide folds into an antibody, and that's the end of the story. But that's not the way it works. I don't think anybody really understands it very well. I certainly don't. But the goat, it's like it customizes every antibody for the job. So it looks at the THC, figures out its shape, and makes an antibody for it. The significance of this is that the goat can make an antibody for anything. I mean, not anything, but can make an antibody for a very large number of things, which means that we can make an immunoassay for a very large number of things with this same technology. They're expensive to develop, but there's limits in what you can do, but there's certainly a wide variety of things you can do with this. And then the last point is that I think the take-home lesson is that this is a biological specificity. In analytical chemistry, we're always looking at the physical characteristics of what it is we're looking at. Does it have a color? Can you react it with something? What's its boiling point? In an immunoassay, you're looking at a biological specificity. I think it's cool. Okay.